Hey, welcome back. Welcome back to Who Me Be a Leader. And remember, this is a blog designed for men. I know we've been getting a lot of comments from women trying to help their man out, and I appreciate that. But it is a blog designed for men to help men be all they can be. But hey, we welcome your comments because we want to address all comments, and if we can aid you in any kind of way, we should try to do that. But you also want to go and visit Life Change Ministry. We also have a ministry called Life Change Ministry, and you're welcome to go there and visit that because we talk about marriage issues and family stuff and parenting and stuff like that. So hey, look through the blog, you know, see where we it's a link that can take you right over to it from Who Me Be a Leader. We welcome you there, and you can leave comments there too for Miss Cynthia Davis. If you as a woman have an issue and you have some things that you want to talk about with another lady, because I definitely can't understand from a lady's perspective, but I would definitely answer any question pertaining to your man and what you have done for that. With that being said, the last time we was with you, we was dealing with a book that we highlighted on our blog called Pastoring Men, and we think that this is a good book. It's actually for pastors, but we're excited about it, and we thought some of the things that were said in it was some stuff that's worth repeating to you. And we hope that you've been keeping up with what's going on, because we're excited about it and we're looking forward to sharing it with you. Remember last time we talked, we asked the question, is pastoring men worth it? And we know that it's worth it because God has called us to be leaders. Remember the structure in the 1 Corinthians chapter 11 verse 3, Christ being the head of every man ahead of woman, God ahead of all. And that is the structure that God has called us in. So men, we have a grave responsibility, but God has equipped us based on 2 Peter. He said he's given us everything we need pertaining to life and godliness, and plus we made in his image. And so we want to dive right into our lesson for today, because I'm excited about it. Because the last time we talked to you about, is it worth pastoring men? Yes, it is. And we also had a comment in the book from a Dave Workman, and he said one of the worst kept secret is how we are equipping men in the church. We're not doing a very good job of equipping men, because I really believe, based on reading this book, and I really agree with him, that we should start from the top down. What I mean by that is this, that we should just start discipling our men and allow them to disciple their family, because we're the primary teacher of our home, men. God has called us the ambassador. He called us the priest of our home, because we need to take God's word more serious. And see, when we begin to take God's word more serious, man, understand this, it will make you more alert in your marriage. It will make you more alert in your fathering. It will make you more alert in your community and your surroundings, because that's what it's about. But it starts with you first. So the last time we asked, is it worth it? And Dave commented, and he said that one of the worst kept secrets is we're doing a bad job. Now, based on 2 Timothy 3:16, it said the word of God is good for correction, reproofing, that we may equip. Because I really believe that you really can't be equipped and adequate unless you've been corrected and reproved. Hear what I'm saying? Because a lot of times it's not as men that we don't know what we're doing is wrong, because we do know. We know what we're doing. But sometimes we need to be reminded of that, and we need to be confronted. And as men, we need to be confronted sometime in order that we can get back on track. Because we're talking about accountability now. Because it's one thing to say something, it's something else to do it. And what I'm saying is this, is that as men, we need that accountability. We need somebody to step in our face and say, hey, what you're doing is wrong based on scripture, not based on my understanding, but based on what God has called you to do. And that's from a biblical one brother to another. You understand? Because remember, he asked the question back way, way back, do it with Cain and Abel. Am I my brother's keeper? Yes, I am. I am your keeper if I'm your brother in Christ, and that's what I am. So last time we say, is pastoring men worth it? Yes, it's worth it. And so the thing about it is, what we want to look at today, though, we want to look at the reason why it's worth it, because we got so much collateral damage done when men are not being discipled. We're making bad decisions. We're making decisions that are not clear. We're not meaning what we say. Nobody can depend on what we say. We're just wavering all over the place. As the scriptures say, we toss to and fro by any wind of doctrine. You got to get solid in your word and dig deep in it. Because remember what the blog stand on. Let's read that scripture that I've started the blog on, because the fact is that I thought this scripture was sufficient for us to start this blog on, because I really believe that it covered the basic. Because one of the things that us as men, we have to be solid in what we thinking, we have to be solid in what we saying, and we have to be solid in what we doing. 1 Corinthians 16:13, it say, be on alert, stand firm in your faith, act like men, be strong, let all that you do be done in love. Be on alert. The only thing that's going to alert you is the word of God. Stand firm in your faith. The scriptures say faith come by hearing, hearing by the word of God, and it's impossible to please God without faith. Be strong, not in your strength. The God is not calling you to be strong in your strength, because your strength gonna give out. He say be strong in his strength and in the power of his might. So men, now that you have it that, hey, if God is not in it, then it won't stand. That's what you gotta understand. But we wanna look at the collateral damage that it does when a man is not discipled. When we look at, we got three statistics here that talks about the collateral damage when a man is not being a disciple. And the first one is, of men who are married between 1970 and 1974, 46.2% will not be married 30 years, after 30 years. The fact is that nobody is going the distance anymore. And the reason why nobody is going the distance anymore, because we're not continuing to learn what it is that God wants us to do. Remember the scripture say, in Psalms 111 verse 10, they say the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. We don't fear God, and so therefore we don't gain the wisdom that we need. When you understand that God is the orchestrator of all things, and all things have to come through him and are built for him and by him. Remember in Timothy, he said, we are his workmanship, created to do his work. We weren't created to do our own. We weren't created for ourselves. We was created to do his work. Remember also in Timothy, he said, study to show yourself approved, work when need not be ashamed, can rightly divide the word of God. Men, we need to know how to rightly divide the word of God. That's the only way that we're gonna really have a chance of instructing our kids, of really leading our life, and most of all, of leading ourselves. And hey, you know, I just really, really love it when God speak to me and unfold some things to me. It's just real exciting. Number two, he say 33%. This is what he said. He said of the 72 million children in America under the age of 18, 33% will go to bed tonight without a biblical father in the house. Because one of the things that is happening, men, we are walking out on our family at an alarming rate. And I'm talking about Christian men. Because one of the reasons why we're walking out is because we don't have any hope. And see, hope will only come in the word of God. Because when you look into 1 Corinthians chapter 13, we call it the love chapter. But if you look later on there in 13 and 7, he talks about that we should believe all things, bear all things, hope in all things, and endure in all things. And if we love like God has called us to love, love never fails. So one of the reasons why we're walking out, because we have no hope. And our hope got to lie in Jesus Christ, because he said, let Christ be ruling every aspect of your life. We can't pick and choose what we want to do when it comes down to God's word. We're either in him or we're not. And he said, if you're going to come to me, you got to believe that I am who I say I am, and that I'm a rewarder of those who seek me diligently. And then that's in when you look into Hebrews chapter 11 verse 6. Hey, until we see you next time, where we'll pick this up and continue the collateral damage. Hey, may God bless you and keep you as our prayer. And remember, a life unexamined is a life worth not living. God bless you.